Hey y'all, Ram Dino here, coming at you from North Carolina. Well, it's been a few weeks since we got together. The Matrix has got me, and then I've been enjoying the trail myself. I was out in the Great Smoky Mountains National Park doing the southern section from Fontana to Newfound Gap. I'll leave a link up here, and you can go and check that out if you haven't already. And then last week, I had to take my daughter back to college. So life goes on, and we get to enjoy it when we can, and you enjoy it as much as we can when we can. So anyway, I am back now, and let's go ahead and get on with the update for the 2019 Appalachian Trail Thru Hikers and what has been going on over the past couple weeks. So let's go ahead and hit it. Current bag tags right now at Harper's Ferry. The last Snowbo through there that I've got a record of, and this may be a day or so old, is bag tag number 1,518. They have 300 flip-floppers that have come through there. And of course, some flip-floppers actually start there. A lot of them do. And then they have had zero Sobo hikers coming through there. So no Sobo hikers yet. The Sobo bubble is probably somewhere still up in New York, although Munn, the trail agent, who's been doing some trail work and some trail magic, and we'll talk about that a little later, but he says he's met a few Sobo hikers up in the northern part of Pennsylvania. So they're coming down to the halfway point, but it'll still be a little bit longer for them. Want to congratulate all those people who have summited lately. We don't have a record of everybody because mostly the folks that we've got a record of is those that we have been tracking. But we don't want to leave folks out. So the best way to do that is to go to my Facebook page at Ram Dino Roaming the Trails and let me know you summited there through my instant messenger and send me a picture. We want to include everybody's picture that we can and get everybody out. Congratulate everybody that has summited, whether we're tracking you or not. But particularly if we are tracking you, we want to include you out there. And if you're watching this channel for the first time, the best way that you can go and find out who summited and just support the Thru Hikers in general is to hit that bell down there and hit that subscribe button, and you'll get my weekly updates. And then you can go over to my Facebook page at Ram Dino Roaming the Trails, and we've got a complete list of everybody with their links there who we are tracking that is out there on the trail now doing their Thru hike. So who we've got summited, the last known number that we had summit was number 272, and that was this morning at about 9 o'clock, and that was Dog Treat. You remember Dog Treat? He was going for to get it in under 100 days so he could get back to school. He is a cadet at the Citadel there in South Carolina, and he did it in 98 days. So he summited day around 9 o'clock. He started from Springer Mountain at number 2,497 was his bag tag number, and he finished number 272 with his tramley on a wet and cold day. So I believe one of the things he mentioned there in his post was there's nothing like summiting and fighting hypothermia at the same time. But it was pretty cold wet, but they summited nonetheless, and we congratulate you, Dog Treat, and your tramley that was with you. Why Not and Handstand, they have also summited, and that is wonderful. And Why Not also, part of her summit, part of her hike was that she did a tribute to Sergeant Ron Sanchez. She hiked with him, got to know him a little bit on the trail before he was taken from us prematurely, and she kind of did a little tribute to him up there at the sign. So we appreciate you doing that, Why Not. Baskets and Garden State have also summited, so congratulations on that. Wrong Way, he summited probably about 2 weeks ago, right after I took a hiatus. So Wrong Way, congratulations, and Wrong Way still out there on the trail. We'll talk about him a little bit, just a little bit from now. Catch Up and Rabbit Foot, the father-son team, they have both summited together. And Pork Chop, he is also summited. So talk about Pork Chop just a little bit. He had to get off the trail due to a medical condition, but he is sort of back on the trail. We'll talk about him a little further. Valkyrie, she is summited on her flip-flop, but she's a little unsure if she's going to continue her Sobo portion of her flip-flop. So Valkyrie, congratulations on the summiting that you did, and we hope that you do continue. If not, good luck to you in whatever you plan to do. Weather report for this upcoming week around Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. You're going to be in the low to high 80s with thunderstorms and rain on Tuesdays, a high possibility and high humidity. Dalton, Massachusetts and Gorman, your weather is going to be remarkably the same. You're going to be in the low to high 70s with a thunderstorm chance again on Tuesday. Not quite as much as Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, but you're going to have somewhere around 30 to 40%, and you're going to have high humidity. Gorham, again, you're the same as Dalton, and Monson, Maine, you're going to be in the high 70s to the low 80s, so you're a little warmer even though you're further north, and you're only going to have a slight chance of thunderstorms on Tuesday, but you are going to be having some high humidities. I've been talking to some different hikers, and they have told me, particularly going through the Whites, that it's getting chilly at night, so it's getting into the 40s and the 50s. And when it's in the 80s and, you know, high 80s, maybe even hitting 90 during the day, 50 feels pretty cold at night. So hopefully you hadn't sent away your puppies or still got a little something to keep you warm that farther up north up there when these chilly nights come in. A couple folks told me they actually hit 31 nights. So you still, if you need to watch the weather, we got a cold front coming in. You need to protect your Sawyer squeezes, because at 30 degrees, it will kill your Sawyer squeeze, believe it or not. Hiker bubble, where is the hiker bubble at? Well, the hiker bubble is moving way far north, and it is somewhere between the Vermont bubble, the Vermont border and the middle area of New Hampshire. So it's stretched out there, and some of it's actually coming into Maine now. The bubble, though, is approaching the Maine border very quickly, and it won't be too much longer, and folks will be summiting Katahdin left and right. So we look forward to those folks who are doing that as they are closing in on their prize. Updates of folks that we have on the trail, Navigator and Era, they have summited Mount Washington, and they're somewhere around Gorham, New Hampshire. Dog Treat, of course, we just mentioned him. He summited today. Postman from the Seraphim Hikes channel, he has reached Springer and he is flipping to Katahdin, and then he'll be subo to Harper's Ferry. Executioner, she is somewhere in Massachusetts and she continues north without Baby Feet, although Baby Feet has been able to get out and do a little bit of hiking, testing her ankle out and seeing how that's going to hold up, and hopefully she'll get out there with Executioner just as fast as she can, but not too fast. But we look forward to those two getting together again and seeing their banter and just their sarcasm. I speak sarcasm, so it's been good to watch them. Our Wonder Woman, they are somewhere around Blue Mountain in Maine. Runa, she is in Massachusetts. 10-4 is around Moosalaki and nursing a stress fracture, and she may have to go home for a few weeks to let that heal. So hopefully she'll be able to deal with that, but we don't want to get out on the trail too soon after an injury like that. So if it takes her a little bit longer, that's okay. Last one to Katahdin wins, right? Like I said before, Wrong Way, he is back on the trail and hiking Sobo with Cheerleader, and they're somewhere around Waynesboro. Champ, he's in New York, and he's planning to flip up into Katahdin somewhere around the 1,500-mile mark, somewhere around Connecticut, and then he'll come back and finish up what he hasn't finished after that. Or Porkchop, as I indicated, he has summited, and he has under 100 miles left. So he's having to go really slow, just do a few short sections at a time. He is out there against doctor's orders, so by all means, Porkchop, we'd rather you survive and thrive. So you take care of yourself. Don't worry about getting that Thru hiker mantra. If that's something you want and you feel like you can, then please, by all means, take your time. But you have done a magnificent job and had such a hike. We've enjoyed watching your trip and watching your journey this whole time. So we're just proud of you no matter what happens, and congratulations on summoning there. Lolly and Pop, they are over the Kinsmen there in the Whites, and they are possibly through the Whites by the time of this recording, by the time you see this. You need to go to check out Oz on the Hiking Sailor channel. Of course, he is off the trail, but he's got a lot of interviews with Thru hikers that he did on his couple weeks that he was out there on the trail on his encounter and his attempt this year, and so some of those are pretty interesting. So I'd encourage you to go take a look at that. Quicksand, he is in the Wildcats and says the nights there has been getting down into the 30s. Amy and John, they are in Vermood or Vermud. So they've been encountering a lot of mud there in Vermont. Minnesota Hikings, they crossed over into Vermont and they say they have had some 45 to 50 degree nights. The Dower Duo, they should be just about through the Whites, if not already through it. Trigger, he is at the Hikers Welcome Hostel there at Mount Mussolacci, and or around that area. He should be at Mount Mussolacci tomorrow, and he has a cast on from a fracture, so he's hiking out there with a cast. So Trigger, good luck to you. Don't re-injure that self or make it worse. If I missed your update, I apologize for that. Please go to my IM over at my the instant messenger function over at Rambino Roaming the Trails and my Facebook page and send me a message, or through my Instagram account just at Simply Rambino, and I'll be glad to get you up there for the next update coming up this week. Off the trail, Gypsy's off and she's back home while her mom recuperates from heart surgery, and she may or may not be coming out here. It just depends on how her mom does, but family comes first, and so we appreciate that, Gypsy. Try, you, if you follow her at all, you know that she is out due to off the trail due to family necessities, and she will not be coming back this year. So Try has done an outstanding job, had an outstanding time on the trail this year, and we're just so proud of everything she accomplished. I mean, from the very beginning, she had to fight injuries and IT band issues, and of course the concussion that she had, and just the heat and everything that everybody else fights out there. But she has so much moxie out there that it's just amazing. I think there's a drink they named after her up there in New England called Moxie. But in any case, Try, we're awful proud of you and what you accomplished, and it was good to watch you. And Try says she is going to continue. She'll be back for another attempt. She'll be starting at Springer, and wants everybody to stay tuned to her channel, continue watching that, and she's still got some updates to come and gear reviews and such as that. So we look forward to your upcoming videos, Try, and we appreciate that. News from the trail down south, I experienced this, and some other hikers have told me that it is very overgrown. Postman told me that coming through the Rhone Highlands there, that the trail was overgrown with stinging nettles. So that is not too good. Nobody wants to be through that mess, and there's not any blue blazes in that area around stinging nettles. So just be aware of that. The trail maintainers in some places, even where they've done a good job, they just can't possibly keep up with the weed growth this year. So I experienced that. You know, the biggest problem I have about getting up in the morning when the trail's overgrown is you just get sopping wet trying to get through it. But that's part of the trail, and that's just trail life. That's what we just have to live with. Runa says that there's some water caches at a crossing at Gilder's Pond in Massachusetts. And then the ATC says the Kirkridge Shelter water supply is broken down due to a power outage there on the pump. So apparently there's a pump there. I'm not familiar with that shelter, but apparently there's a pump that or power that supplies that pump, that they had a power problem there. And Monk, the trail angel we've talked about before, Monk was hiked in, I think it's several miles that he had to hike in. He hiked in 8 gallons of water, and he got there, and the water source was working fine. So I don't know if that just hadn't been updated from the ATC or not, but Monk says it's working fine. So hopefully everything will be going good there with that. And again, Monk is a trail angel, and he's been stocking water caches around Palmerton, Pennsylvania, near the Delaware Water Gap, to include Delaware Water Gap, Lehigh Gap, Little Gap, Smith Gap, and Wind Gap. So all those places that he is stocking and checking on regularly. Monk, we greatly appreciate what you're doing. I know that I have received a lot of thanks from other hikers out there who greatly appreciate those water caches you're putting out there, and other trail angels. I know there's other folks that do water caches out there. Water caches can be somewhat controversial. I check with the ATC to see what their stance is on it, and here's what they sent me. Kind of a screenshot of what they sent me, and it talks about food and it talks about drinks, but doesn't talk about water. So it doesn't specifically say they don't want you to put water caches out. It does talk about leaving personal property on National Park Service land is illegal. And the idea also is they don't want you to leave stuff there because other hikers will leave trash for the people that are stocking the water caches, and you know, they'll just leave their trash there. They don't want to pack it out thinking that somebody else will get it, and of course that attracts animals. But I've just had so many people tell me they appreciate that, and there's also there at Sam's Gap, there's a hostel owner that's taken upon himself to be a policeman for the trail, and It's my understanding he is getting rid of those water caches that are placed out there at Sam's Gap. I actually had a Thru hiker tell me that hostel owner, and I'm not going to mention their names, but that hostel owner told him that one of the reasons he does it is so people will come up to his place and get water. So that's just wrong in my book. So I don't think that's right to make yourself the policeman of the trail. You know, if you're just going to do it where it's convenient, why not do it at all the places all up and down the trail where people do the water caches? But I've had enough people that have thanked Monk and other trail angels and have left notes and appreciate that. And even though the ATC is a little fuzzy at it, I had a quote that kind of came to mind here. And the quote was, "But when a long train of abuses and usurpations pursuing invariably the same object invents a design to reduce them under absolute despotism, it is their right, it is their duty to throw off such government and to provide new guards for their future security." So basically, paraphrasing, that means that, you know, when the government or the government entity is wrong, they're wrong, and we should throw off those chains and do what needs to be done to make things right. So does that mean that we need to be throwing food and stuff out there? No, I don't agree with leaving food out there that is that somebody's not watching over. But water doesn't have a smell to it. If other hikers will just stop leaving their trash, I think that's the main thing. Oh, and by the way, that quote comes from the Declaration of Independence. So it's kind of hard to argue with that. So the main thing is, thanks guys, the Trail Angels, Monk, and the rest of you that are leaving those water caches out there. That's getting people through some desperate places. I looked at where Sam's Gap is, and Sam's Gap, the closest water point south of there is a sixth of a mile off the trail, so that's 1.2 round trip that you've got to get water, and then the water before that is a unreliable source, and then the water before that is contaminated through the Superfund site. So Sam's Gap, I think, is one of the places that really needs that kind of water supply, as does the other places. And enough Thru hikers out there are thanking Monk and the rest of them that I agree with that. So keep up the good work, Monk. Bear reports, still got the same bear reports we got there in the Smokies. Pretty much all the shelters, they've got warnings up through there. On my trip, we didn't have any problems at all with bears, didn't see any. Cosby Knob Shelter has officially is closed right now. Apparently, one of the ridge runners told me, apparently what happened is a hiker cooked his food and left his backpack in there in the shelter that night, and so that bear got adjusted to that being there and got aggressive. So now he expects it to be like that all the time. So that kind of ruined it for a lot of folks there, and if you'll look at where the Cosby Knob shelter is, you got to do some big miles to work around that shelter. So let's take notice of that, folks, and don't be that guy that doesn't practice good bear hang methods. Still got the same alerts up for around Grayson Highlands, around those areas, and also in Vermont due to some multiple bear incidences around Goddard Shelter, which is temporarily closed, the Kid Gore, Story Spring, and Stratton Pond shelters, and then in Massachusetts, the Sherman Brook Primitive Camping Area, they've asked to not eat or camp or tent with food and everything out there. So I asked you to utilize the bear boxes on site. So still got some bear issues going on, probably will until they go back into the hibernation. As I said before, I just uploaded my section hike on the Great Smoky Mountains National Park, and that was pretty neat. Enjoyed that immensely. That was just a good time, but as I always say, that was the toughest section I've done yet. So it was a tough section. I hope you can go take a look at that and check it out and leave a comment for me. On Hikers Helping Hikers this week, I wanted to thank everyone that had contributed to the GoFundMe account that we had started there for the victims of the tragedy that occurred in May. The murder of Sergeant Ron Sanchez and the injury to the unknown or unnamed hiker. both all of that money, with the exception of a small portion, has been distributed. The small portion hadn't been, because it came in after I had already distributed the rest of it. And so that's a very small amount, probably less than $20, but I will be adding a little bit to that and contributing, making a contribution to the ATC in the name of Sergeant Ron Sanchez. So thanks everybody for doing that. That those funds have been distributed at this time, and that account of that that campaign now is closed. So thanks a lot for doing that. We appreciate that. I know that the families on both sides of are very appreciative. They just appreciate the hiker community coming together. I made sure that that they knew that those proceeds were not for me, that they were from the hiker community, and they understood that, and they are very grateful for that. So I appreciate y'all coming together and being the hiker community that you can be. Well, folks, that is all I've got for this week. Appreciate you hanging around here to the end. And as always, appreciate you, and we'll see you out there.